It's 8:35. These are tomatillos. Look at how good that looks. That one there.
Those are the ones we started under the plastic too. Remember?
In the house, in the, yeah, is it?
Yeah.
That almost looks like a little tomatillo on there. Right down there. This would be zucchini. Zucchini. All right, come on, Therapy. Come back from the plastic. Out of these, there's five out here. Everything out here is planted within 2 days of each other, if that far apart. Usually I thought it was all one day. Get out of there, sunflowers. But look at how big this one is. And that one there.
Yeah.
And then look at the other three, how small. Although they all look healthy. See it right down in there?
Yeah, I don't know if that's tomatillo.
Or just another bud. These are the Italian runner beans right here.
No, it might be a flower. If it's a flower, then the tomatillo will come out after that.
So that's all from here. I'm going to put tomatoes in here, two to three rows. And then this will be tomatoes, and then two or three rows of peppers. And that one there.
What are these?
Those are the runner beans. I know, those are purple pole beans.
Purple pole beans. Yeah.
We got six purple pole beans planted over there, and four of them are coming up.
Five. And that one there?
One, two, three, four. Where's the fifth one?
Oh, I guess that's I thought I seen
one. Yeah, see this here, I think I have too much lime. These leaves are yellow. The plant looks okay though. It's just, you know, too much lime in there for that one. And this one here. I just planted a couple here too, Black Beauty in there yesterday, and I planted a Black Beauty. No, I planted a Black Beauty in that opening right there, and I think over there, even though that's for the golden, because those two rows were going to be the yellow golden zucchini, and then one Black Beauty in that plant there, Black Beauty. But I just planted the seeds yesterday, the 5th of May. We got two watermelon that are Jubilee and two are Sugar Baby. So right now I have that one there, which is a Sugar Baby or the Jubilee, and then the one right down from it is the other type, whatever brand that one was. And then on this side, just the opposite, although it looks like one's starting to come up right here. All of them? Oh, okay, all right. It looks like one right down there. You can see right there. So we got four watermelon plants, two Jubilee and two, whatever I said the other one was. And one of each is growing. It looks like maybe a second one. And then these are honeydew. Nothing's coming up out of that one there, but look at that. They were planted at the same time. Okay, and so, as you go back east, you're going east now. Ooh, damn. Okay, that's the Purple Hull. Purple Hull pea, which, again, you can't hardly find those too well. A lot of people don't know about Purple Hull peas. My mom had some in her garden before she passed away on December 28th, 2012. And we had a bag with some in there. We weren't sure if that's what they were, but I thought I put two or three in there, and there's like four of them in there. Got two or three there. Got three here. And three here. Purple Hull peas. They're about 4 inches, 4 inches above the ground. And then over here, black-eyed peas. Starting right there. Black-eyed pea. One, two, well, I mean, I'm just counting the location. Two, three, four, five, six. I got eight locations of black-eyed peas. But as you can see, it's hard to hold this camera with my cane, so that's why it's so messed up. There's two there. Looks like two in there. There's two in there. A lot of people, they say they put down one, they put down two or three seeds in each place. I usually just put one in, but you know, I didn't bow to pressure, but I went ahead and just put down two, and you see two grow, because generally, whenever I planted a heirloom seed, a plant comes from that one heirloom seed. So the ones, if you see two of them in here, I drop two in there. I don't normally do that, but see, like right here, these are what's green peas, sweet pea, arrow pea, however you want to call them. I said before they were black-eyed peas, but I've got them over here. I have one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, five. Five locations of green peas. And again, I dropped two seeds in, or I call them seeds, because they're peas, but they're seeds. And see, there's two growing there. Two of them growing right there. Nothing yet on this one. One growing right here. Okay. And then again, that's broccoli. I don't know if that's what that is right. I can't see if my cane is in there right now or not. Gosh, this broken viewfinder doesn't help any. Anyway, there's my cane is pointing at some broccoli, I think. Right there. Right there. But there's four places for broccoli over here. The first one is growing up big time. Look at that one. Then it looks like it's possibly right there. And this one right here is broccoli, right down there. It looks like a weed, a broadleaf weed, but it is the broccoli. Then you got these growing right here. Okay. Then this is a different heirloom brand of broccoli. Now this one's all coming up pretty good. You see that one there? There's two in there, two or three. Two there, one or two there, and one right there. Okay, broccoli. I planted the first four, and I waited about a week, maybe two, and I planted these four. And look how, like I said, look how fast that one's coming up, though. Those two, three. Sunflowers, these are sunflowers all around the garden, by the way. Titan sunflowers I got around the garden. Most of them are growing, about 90% are growing. See some small. It's just nature in general. It's coming up differently. Cucumbers, we got one, two, three, four, five, six, or seven. Yeah, a couple of them, there's growing a couple in one place. These are the Italian runner bean. I had two planted down here. Again, this is the ones on the north end of the garden, which is kind of a bad mistake, I guess, because I was told they run south. They've got about 12 inches and they'll be out of the garden. That's why I don't know how I'm going to run them. If I can put some twine back and forth between stakes, and I don't think they'll run east and west, though. And my okra. This is green pod and spineless that we planted out here. And all of them are grown except for that first one. Burgundy okra is in the middle two rows. Those are all growing except for two spaces down there. You got one on the first end down there. That's the burgundy one. Burgundy. Burgundy. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit, maybe. Again, there's a crack in my viewfinder, so if I'm off a lot of times, it's because I can't see. I'm trying to see the plant. Let's do the spineless and the long green pod that are mixed together in here somehow. So I think these are mainly the long green pod okra. Nothing there yet. Here. Oh, look, we got grass. See, this is hard to do it with the camera, so I'm not even gonna do it now. I was doing it before, picking off the grass and all this. It's easier to pick it by hand. It's work, but you know, you gotta do it. So all this will have to be picked out when I'm not videoing it. Then we got, these are the only two spaces of the burgundy okra where nothing is growing yet. It's right there and straight across from right there. And then the first row again is spineless and the long pod green. And you got one, nothing growing right there. Two, there's one growing. Three, nothing's growing. Four, there are two growing there. See, so they'll make up for each other. Then here, there's nothing growing in that one. Here's one growing. Nothing's going in that one. See, and this one just came up within the last day. Like I said, so you can see how they come up sometimes after a week or two of sitting here, and then all of a sudden they all pop up. So anyway, see, the rows run north to south, or south to north. And we got so much more yet to plant out here. Tomatoes, I just started like, I want to say 24, I'm not positive, 24 tomatoes yesterday, 18 pepper plants, 3 eggplants, and then I did 3 cayenne pepper, 3 of a different type of pepper. I can't remember the pepper now. More peppers than we have lately, different varieties. So here in this garden, after that purple pole bean, which is what we had the strings for them to latch onto, that's kind of like what we could have done, but that's what I did with this. I just used those little fencing things right there, little green fencing arches. I was just going to leave those, and then I thought, well, I'll put string through them too so they can latch onto them right away and just start crawling. Same thing with the cucumber here. These tomato stakes here, and then I put string going from each tomato stake. So they have things to climb on. This one here, like I say, we could always put another one up about another 8 inches higher. These are hummingbird feeders out here. The hummingbirds are out on these all the time, which is good. And with sunflowers all the way along the east end over there, most of the north end. I don't have anything on this end right here, on the west end of that number. This is the number 3 garden, the big one. And then I have mammoth sunflowers over here, and then I just sprinkled a bunch of the Titan sunflowers to fill the little gaps that were in here. I don't know why these didn't grow as good as the Titans do, but you can see the mammoth, or not the mammoth, torch. Torch sunflowers are the ones, it looks like a weed. This looks like a wild sunflower, but they're heirloom. Everything out in this garden is heirloom, but you see the ones down below, all those petals, the leaves, right? I can't see in here. Okay, you see that right there? All those are the Titan sunflowers, like I have on the far side over there. That's about 8 to 10 inches, a lot of them. And then they go all the way down to the end here. And my wife put marigolds all the way down. We just put seeds in there. And I have another pack and a quarter. Like I said, I think they're a fall flower, but we planted them anyway just to have them in the ground. So if they come up in the fall, they'll come up in the fall. So that's it. A lot of zucchini, beans, and okra mainly. Like I say, if we can get those tomatoes, it's at least 18 to 24 tomato plants. I've got 2 that are up from another planting about a month ago. And then yesterday I planted 24, I believe it is. I think it's four or five different types of tomatoes. And then, like I say, peppers. We've got little spots, like I say, well, this is where everything is now. We could probably put a pepper plant right here, right down there. And we got over in the back there, we could probably put 2 there. We could put 1 or 2 there. Same thing, 1 or 2, 1 or 2. And then over here, a row of, probably 3 rows of tomatoes right here. From the purple pole bean. And then we got 3 rows of tomatoes right here. And then another 4 rows of tomatoes over here. And then 2 to 3 rows of peppers on the end. And then around the house there, we've got where we're going to put peppers. Like we did last year, we grew a bunch of peppers. That's going to be a good spot for peppers to grow. It's like a partial sun. It gets some sun, but partial. This gets, the most sun is number 3 garden over there in the back. Because you can see in the back part of it already, the north part of the garden has got sun. Then number 1 garden here will get some more sun. And like I said, as the sun comes up, then number 2 garden. Even though tomatoes prefer sun, that's why I want to put 3 rows here. And then the first few rows here will be tomatoes and then peppers over there. So, and the biggest downside to everything, you see that field over there? How many hundreds and hundreds of acres? See this? See the fields all around me? See off in the distance? Let me zoom up that way. Okay. way up on that hill there. You see all that crop there? All right, zoom back out. Okay, this is a farm owned by a gentleman, which his son farms this land. He helps the farmland too. He helps his son farm his land. That's all. I want you to see all of it. Off in the distance there. Let me zoom in. So I'm going to make it what I can see on this viewfinder. It'll look like I'm looking at it. Yeah, that's about the same size of everything that I'm looking at. See, all that farmland over there in the distance, the field across the road. I'm going to walk out front, which is east. This is what we have to live with. That's southeast. That's south. Southeast. East. Northeast. North. Northwest. West. Well, you get the picture. Everything out there, Monsanto corn. That's why I'm not growing any corn. I would not try to grow corn out here. Don't like being out here because of this. Trust me, the health hazards that I believe we're going through is, I don't know, we'll see what happens. But there's our garden. People need to start growing some food. I mean, you can't have nothing this size. We've been fortunate to have this size. It's like a double-edged sword. Good to have this size, but then look at what's all around us. But at the same token, we do the best we can. It's better than buying the crap you would get at China Mart.